Everyone, this morning I have rewritten a column I wrote in 2010, and I'd like to read it to you. It's about the divine feminine and divine masculine awakening again. The first exhalation from source, the primal consciousness, and one undivided white still light, everything floats in unity and connection, in a symbiosis with all that exists. Once, eons and eons ago, in the primal consciousness, out of which everything came forth, an impulse arose to become conscious of itself. Unity experienced a desire to deep within to express itself. This impulse of desire from unity was manifested immediately. So strong was the manifestation power present in this desire. Unity manifested another, same unity outside itself, which divided unity. Both felt the longing deep within to flow together and also to express themselves more and more. The powerful longing to flow together and come together manifested new creations outside themselves. Stars and planets manifested. After some time, the desire arose to live a human experience. In order to realize this, special vehicles of consciousness were manifested for the ones who felt the courage to go first. The purpose of the human game was to investigate and live through all aspects of the human experience. To investigate and live all aspects of consciousness. A collective journey began. The journey. To be able to play the game, it was necessary to descend into consciousness from unity, more and more into duality and separateness. This was a gradual process. During the journey, different games were played on different planets. These games took place in cycles, and every time there came a moment that the game had been played to the end. Game over. These games have left deep, deep memories and layers around the collective consciousness, and therefore also around the individual consciousness. Memories of power and powerlessness, superiority and inferiority, uncertainty, lust, greed, arrogance, in short, experiences of duality and separation. The game on planet Earth. Once, eons and eons ago, a cosmic council of wise ones gathered who discussed where the next experience game could be played. A game where all those involved before would play a part. The purpose of this game was to see through all the experiences of duality and to eventuality come to a point where a reversal could take place. At a deep point of duality, of denseness, a moment of reversal would be possible. There would be a moment when all those involved had the opportunity to join in defining the outcome of the game. Never before had this been possible. Reversal. We have now arrived at the point in evolution of maximum density of our consciousness. Once, before the game on Earth began, we made an agreement with each other that at the points on an alarm would go off inside ourselves. Deep inside ourselves, we would remember we are one. A deep longing would wake us up so that we could walk the path back to unity. Many have heard this alarm go off. Many have set off on the path. On the way back, we encounter the memories as obstacles in the layers around our collective and individual consciousness. Memories we have accumulated during the many human experiences. We may now see through these obstacles. You can view these obstacles as illusory layers that have been laid around our source consciousness. Illusory layers that have been laid around pure consciousness. Illusions concerning primal trust, sexuality, symbols, worth, birth, source, religion, love, freedom, joy, power, creation, creative power. The effect of the illusions is so powerful that for many people, the source consciousness has completely disappeared out of view. As a result of the many human experiences, the view on the source has completely disappeared from the picture. But now is the time that we are called to see through the workings of the illusions. The seeds of awakening have been laid in every one of us. The seeds can start to germinate. The time is now. For this to be possible, however, it's necessary that we understand the workings of the illusions in the right way. Otherwise, new illusory layers will just be created around our consciousness. And that, of course, doesn't bring us any further in the game. We have all received eight keys to see through the illusory layers. Everybody has a different blend of illusory layers around the source consciousness. Depending on the human experiences he, she has accumulated in this life and past lives. The experiences of others also lie subconsciously around your source consciousness. An illusionary layer around your consciousness contains thought patterns, defense mechanisms, behavior patterns, prejudgments, assumptions, concepts, ideas. Characteristic is that the illusions are not yours, but they feel as if they are yours. Therefore, you react automatically to something coming from outside. It's as if you are pre-programmed. On the personal level, this is what happened. And that is how it works. Illusions work like a program. The programs have been laid in you during all the human experiences and in this life during your upbringing at home and at school, the culture you live in, the religion, even if you are not actively involved in a religion. The religious patterns still lie stored as veils around your consciousness. In your consciousness, gatekeepers take care that the gates of an illusionary layer only open after you have fully accepted the gift of the gatekeeper in yourself. After you have seen through an illusionary layer, you can pass through the gates and the illusion no longer has a hold on you. That doesn't mean that there won't be triggers coming from the illusion anymore. But you no longer react automatically from the illusion to these triggers. You have a choice now. You no longer fall back in consciousness once you have completely passed through the gates. Your knowing from life experience, the gatekeeper's gift now becomes available to yourself, the other and the large whole, whereby the path has become available for the other. The other has to walk the path her, himself, want to make steps her, himself. That also means accepting the conscious of passing through the gate. Woman and man concepts. Many dualities lie stored within the concept woman, feminine, and man, masculine. The natural creative power of both woman and man was invalidated because an unnatural division took place within the woman, man, human, with as a result many entanglements, confusions and reversals around the woman and man image, human image. Many illusions take away the view of the woman, man, human, and especially on the creative power on both. The essence of the invalidation lies in the way of creative power, and they both naturally have in them. Releasing creative power in woman and man. The creative power of woman and man is released again once the mechanism kneading between woman and man has been seen through. And the mechanism has been seen through. Your creative power is released once you see how the mechanism of kneading works inside yourself, inside your consciousness. This goes for woman as well as man. A woman naturally gives her life vitality, her life's energy. That is her source experience, her creative power. The feminine kneading. As soon as woman dissolves all dependence, including spiritual neediness, inside herself, she finds the loving bed for her power inside herself. The moving along with the outside, for example, her husband, automatically stops. All false, unreal needing outside herself dissolves. She can now drink from her own source experiences. She now knows by having lived through it that she can find everything she needs in life inside herself. The reaching out to others from a false, unreal needing stops. She trusts that she receives from life what she needs to fully blossom. That which she really needs automatically resonates with her and comes to her without any effort. What she needs during this process is trust. The feeling of trust is now deeply anchored within her as a primal trust. Because of this, she can relax, find peace with herself, in her own source. Her life goes as it goes. She doesn't need a story anymore. Divine feminine. Her vitality is now freely available for co-creation. Emotions like fear, self-doubt, confusion, insecurity, and entanglement no longer pull her back out of her strength. She sees these defense mechanisms for what they are, both in herself and in the other. She knows she might still have issues. These no longer distract her from herself and what she has to offer to the living together. She can stay focused on the giving and no longer withdraws. Divine femininity, the carrier of life, the birth giver, nourish and nurturer. The healed sick psyche, the sick masculine in both man and woman, protects this wonderful given life. Pitfall. When, as a woman, you haven't yet actually met the source inside yourself, when your source hasn't yet descended, the descending of your source in your belly feels like an orgasm, and the cosmos cheers along with you at the moment of the descent, you grow in your womb power, you feel the longing for your source deep inside you. A source longing of the soul can be awakened inside you. You project this longing outside yourself. As long as you haven't experienced the source experience deeply, don't know it from the inside, you will want to fill up the emptiness inside with outside experiences. You don't see that you're not your source yet, and you want to pull it in from the outside. You start grabbing for money, sex, love, through your man, for example, because you think, story is mine, that he ought to give you the source experience, love, for example. Or you start giving away your life energy without being open to receive. A man naturally wants to be really needed. He wants to be available in freedom, in his heart's love. That is his source experience, his creative power. The masculine wanting to be needed. Once he can feel the difference in himself between being needed and false, unreal being needed, he will automatically stop giving his life force away and will be able to remain in his heart's connection. He now knows and recognizes the power of his heart's love, which is unconditional love. He no longer needs to withdraw inside himself, flee, or, for example, get up on the barricades to battle in a war, fight. He can now say no strongly to false being needed and feel the difference inside himself when and where he is really needed. His life energy, which is his sexual energy, his creative power. His creative power is now available for what he genuinely wants to connect with in freedom, out of real love. Divine masculine. The era of the Grail Knight has arrived. The guardians of the womb, guardians of the earth, soul whisperers. This is a new term for many men, and a realization that your own awakening is inextricably linked to the re-emerge of the feminine in yourselves and in the woman around you. The time of the separate masculine spiritual path is over. What this world needs more than anything else at this moment is men who are committed to their souls, to feel all their feelings with a radical honesty, to choose life and love over security and power, to leap out from the safety of the bank into the middle of the fast-flowing river, to realize that one of greatest powers in existence is the courage, lion-hearted love of awakening man. This love has the power to bloom open not just yourselves, but also the woman that you love. And by giving it all, you will receive it all. Become this is the true connection and sharing on all levels, both physically, emotionally, mentally, spiritually, and energetically. And with the all, the one, divine masculinity, the protector of the divine feminine, which is the carrier of life, the birth giver, nourish and nurturer. The divine masculine says, we are all invited on this planet, and I truly live together on Mother Earth. I protect all life, and I stand for my own healing, and the healing of Mother Earth, and the next generations. I will no longer lean on the feminine and expect her to clean up the mess on Earth. I take care of my own growth. I no longer offer life and the feminine. The divine masculine says, I am touchable. The healed sick psyche, the sick masculine in both men and women, protects this wonderful given life. I added a song, Awake My Soul. It's a beautiful song. You can listen to it. Of course. Pitfall. Both collectively and individually, men feel a trigger on the emotion being needed. Men can feel a suction in being needed. The more suction he experiences, the more resistance. It feels as if his life energy, money, sex, heart's love, freedom, is being channeled. And so, being needed can feel too heavy for him, which makes him afraid to deeply connect from his heart's love. So great is the subconscious fear inside him of being disproven. He once has the experience that he was made into the source of someone or something else. Once he was disproven in his heart's love, because of this, he started filling up the experience of being needed in the outside world. He starts filling up the emptiness in his heart with outside experiences. He goes out to save the world, for example, and gets sucked into a war doing so. Or he starts investigating the power behind the power. Anything better than having to feel the emptiness in his heart. And feeling the emptiness in his heart lies his transformation. As soon as man is healed in his heart's strength, his heart's love with real love. And he remembers his creative force. He can no longer be manipulated by those in power to go and help an invisible go in other countries in the name of peace on earth, the good, etc. He can no longer be manipulated to be sent into a war in the name of peace on earth, or the good. He can no longer be manipulated to save. He now understands that nobody needs to be saved. Embedding. Real men and women are an embedding for each other. They are capable of fully picking up each other's talents and bringing them further. The desires from the ego are no longer leading. Reaction patterns are no longer being lived out. Real men and women are essentially powerful co-creators, each from his own creative power. Betrayal. Accepting gifts from outside feels like a deep betrayal to yourself and your system. You rape and disprove yourself. This translates externally in this time. Not accepting it in yourself as a pattern, which makes you, as a human, keep on looking for the source experiences outside yourself. Looking for the source outside yourself feels safe and familiar, which makes it possible for it to be accepted. Feelings of safety and primal trust are no source experiences. However, the source outside yourself doesn't bring forth anything substantial. It doesn't procreate. Looking for the source outside yourself leads to fear, hyperactivity, confusion, entanglement, restlessness, because it feels like a deep betrayal of yourself. For inside yourself, you know that you already have everything in you. You have everything inside you to be your. You have everything inside you to be. You really are. You yourself are the reason that you move away from your source. You really have everything inside you to come to creation. You are already there. We are already there. All we need to do is reconnect it. As soon as you leave your creation to yourself, let your life force flow freely, you automatically start to flow together in co-creation, resonance. Passionate life forces start to flow together. Insight in the essence of sexuality. The longing for unity, for flowing together, lies towards in the consciousness of every human being. Often a person is not aware of this. This longing for unity can also be translated as the longing for co-creation. This creation can be a child, or a beautiful painting, or a great work of art. The conception can come either from outside yourself or from inside. From outside, it can be experienced in a pregnancy, and when the impulse comes from inside in a beautiful painting. The longing is felt as sexual energy, as sexual desire. Once you have insight in the essence of sexuality, you have conscious choices available in how you want to express your sexual energy. Sexual reaction patterns are no longer being indulged. Wise women and men have cleaned up their sexual reaction patterns. In this way, as a wise woman and a wise man, you are conscious link in the evolution on, and you understand that you are co-creator of the game. As long as we didn't pick up this together, we lapse into old patterns and get more and more entangled. which can have a very destructive effect. I mention this so we can become conscious of it. I offer you an alternative to fearfully withdrawing inside yourself or directing your anger outside yourself. Inside yourself, you can develop a flawless feeling for when something doesn't connect with you on all levels. You can develop a very sharp and clear feeling inside yourself for what is true for you, what resonates inside you. Because of this, you no longer need to lose connection with yourself, and the confusion and entanglement in you come to an end. Self-doubt comes to an end. Ask yourself if something that is being offered to you feels right for you. You feel it in the restlessness in your body. When you have seen something, peace is the result. Feel the difference in yourself. Yes, there are still issues. Or not being picked up. The essential that you bring is not being picked up. No connection is being made with it. The game has been played to the end. We may start playing a new game from our own wisdom. Letting each other exist, stand in freedom. No tax added, no load added. Acknowledgement, recognition of yourself, each other, the larger whole, may, can become the source experience. A discernment in the old and the new. Recognition of the old and the new. You recognize the old game by fear, depression, psychosis, schizophrenia, entanglement, confusion, sacrifice, the secret. You recognize the new game by inner peace, clarity, release, effortless, letting each other exist, stand in freedom, no taxes added, no load added, the abundance principle, co-creation out of passion, which is supra sex and no super sex. The game goes on. Unconditional love and energetic sexuality, supra sex. Jesus, the allegorical Jesus, metaphorical, is that the right word? I don't know. Jesus and his message worldwide, there are people who can really penetrate to the core of the illusions. They can penetrate to the essential message that lies hidden within the illusions. These people are the pioneers. In this way, Jesus went ahead of us 2000 years ago. In the time of Jesus, the consciousness of many was not so accessible yet that they could understand the essential message of Jesus. People didn't have ears to hear and eyes to see yet. A single fellow traveler in Jesus' time could pick up the message. Jesus' most important fellow traveler was Mary Magdalene. She understood Jesus' words. She understood the deep meaning. She understood change. Humanity was offered with Jesus' words, or was it in fact her message that was fully heard? and understood by Jesus? And was he merely the one given words to it for many? Did the story of Mary Magdalene still need to be protected because her message would in that time have been invalidated completely? Would have been ridiculed? Would have been undermined? Would people have been able to accept her message in themselves? Would it have been picked up? Probably not. There were so many prejudgments against women in that time. It really had to be a man who was the one to bring an essential message for humanity. The story goes and goes in cycles. Do you recognize this? In our current time, are men accepting the true understanding of woman? You may think about this. You may feel it in yourself. Unconditional love. Mary Magdalene understood the message of unconditional love. She understood and felt through the essence of sexuality, of sexual energy. She understood the longing of humanity to once again flow in unity with themselves, the other, and the larger whole. She understood that if people could accept the message of unconditional love inside themselves, people would never be the same. From unconditional love, there is room for everyone to be on planet Earth, nobody excluded. From unconditional love, everyone is welcome in the other's heart of the level of essence. Unconditional love sees the essential in herself, in himself, and the other, and through that also in the larger whole. Unconditional love knows no prejudgment. Everything can just be as it is. Unconditional love allows you to end up at yourself, at your source, seemingly without any effort. Unconditional love leaves the essence of sexual energy free. Lets sexual energy flow freely. Lets the creative life force power flow freely. Yes, Mary Magdalene's message was doomed to remain unheard for 2,000 years. Will it be heard in our current time? Gate of unconditional love. But now, in this time, there are one again, the divine ones, who have fully heard her message. They have opened the gate of unconditional love, real love. Because of this, the complete message of unconditional love has become available for humanity. And with the message of unconditional love, the message of the essence of sexual energy also becomes available again for everyone. Spiritual transformation. We are in the middle of a spiritual transformation, and it's all about knowing thyself. Then you are in your own individual power and start living from a true togetherness and sharing with your Mother Earth in alignment with all there is. No more manipulation, no more harvesting of your sexual life force energy. Just you flowing wherever life wishes you to flower. from our renewed energy structure, our renewed, transformed psyche, our outer world needs to and will change too. The ones who comprehend this are and will be the parents of the new earth, midwives and men, of course, who help humanity to be born on the new earth, by living the new themselves in their own togetherness. Being the embedding for the next generations. Via the New Earth Life Academy, homeschooling from the new paradigm, you learn how you can offer the next generations a free unconditional grounding and foundation. That's already possible. The foundation of freedom, of perception of self and experience of self. There are children out there with beautiful and powerful consciousness and talents because they are born on the free foundation of the spirit of times, from which they feel the inner space to express themselves. Let's embed them. Thanks for listening. And I look forward to meet you in the homeschooling class or the study group on Facebook. I will put on the links beneath this video. Thanks.